Hello folks, and welcome to this wee painting tutorial or video on painting techniques. Now, as you can see in front of you, there's a primed canvas and I've got a selection of brushes and paint, and I'm just going to go ahead and paint this. I've already drew out in pencil the idea of what I'm trying to achieve, but what I actually achieve might differ, so here goes. So I'm just applying paint to my brush and I'm starting here and I'm just adding the paint and going over. Now you're wanting to get a kind of smooth effect, like a kind of a believable kind of sky, not too thick with paint where you're getting heavy brush strokes or whatever, but just enough coverage and the thinning of the paint to give the illusion of the sky, if you understand. So I'll just keep applying the paint. This bit's pretty simple, you know. I mean, if you get a wee hair, just use a corner of your brush and take it off. I learned that one off of Bob Ross when I used to watch him. But Bob's technique for me at this stage in my art career's a wee bit kind of hard to achieve, you know. So I'm having fun with my own style just now, you know. And I'm doing a wee bit of studying into other artists when they were alive and how much money their work sells for present day, you know. And I'm trying to introduce this concept that although I'm 49 and alive just now, then the signature seems to be the attraction in art, well, apart from a good looking piece of art as well, but the concept I'm trying to introduce is that doesn't need to be too accurate there, so don't worry about it. The concept I'm trying to achieve is selling prints of my work, signed prints, right? You imagine back in the day when artists like your Monets and your Van Goghs or whatever were selling art, and many died poor or didn't make any money from their art. But look at what I find shopping now is the fact that the price that artwork is going for now compared to when they produced it in their life. So, like I said, I'm in the process of trying to produce artwork and sell prints, signed prints now, limited edition. And the limited edition artworks that I sell, each person that buys an artwork from the limited edition range will be noted. So that they're, I don't want to call it an investment, I call it a legacy. So a legacy, a mark that they're leaving behind for their family members continues to hold value. Now I hope you can grasp that concept. Now, like I said about Bob's technique and my technique, Bob's technique produces amazing works, right? No doubt about it. But my technique, I find, works for me easily and could work for you. Should you want to pursue an art career yourself? You know? Yes, we technique here is what's known as cutting in, just where you come to align with paint. Right. So that's the sky, right? And what I would do here is, because I love that colour of blue, to do the water. I don't know if you can make it out on the lower part of the painting, but to do the water, all I would do is add a wee bit of white paint, right, and get a good wee mix with the remainder of the paint I used for the sky, just to make it a wee bit lighter, and it's not the same as the sky, so you're changing the colours and bringing a different dynamic to the painting. And I'll just show you, here is where the water is, right? So as you can see, it's a bit lighter. And again, I'll do the bulk first. So that's a good way to approach it. You do the bulk of the main part of the area, which is to be painted. You know, you just mix it, and that would take us over to here. Now, the fact that some wee bits of white are coming through, and the blue, that's what Bob would refer to as a happy accident. Because to me, that's like a wave, you know. And I'm not going to worry too much about getting over that here, because you'll see what happens later. The land is in darker contrast to the sea or the water, so I can always just do the land to make a contrast. I usually go for greens with a land, but I'll show you my technique of how I make the green land. In fact, I'm going to use a smaller brush here, because after you've done the bulk, right, and you get more intricate bits today, if it's going to be kind of job to cut in, then you would use a smaller brush. So I've still got the paint colour here I was using, and I'll use a smaller brush. I'll use this wee one. Right, so I'll just go in here. Take a wee bit of paint out of there. Straighten that out. Start in the corner. Straighten that out. Come down with the mountain and a corner and straighten that out. Right? So you can see what I've done here. I've made the sky and the water pretty simply through the blues. And it's just a matter of cutting in with a smaller brush. And this is a kind of, I've not decided yet whether or not to make that the beach area or a continuation of the mountain. But you'll see what's happening. Over to the wall. And this was just a wee bit of land I had jotting it. We've got my paint out of there. For that. Come over here. The veins are out there going mad. They're all half a school because of this virus. You know, my mothers and fathers must be going up the wall now. You know. So I'll just cover that up. Wee bit more paint, and that should be done. Just take that wee bit away. Right, so I'm happy with that. I'm nearly 15 minutes in, so I'm going to put these brushes in water, give them a right good clean, right? And then I'm going to use another brush and move on with another colour of, I'm going to try and get a grey of some sort. So what I'm going to do is, I don't want to waste any colours I've used, so I'm going to use a blue and a white. Now that might seem a wee bit strange to you, but it's only volume you're using, because you're not using colour. If you know what I mean? You're using the volume of the paint already used. Right, so I'll just mix it all up and see what I come up with. Aye, it's looking good. Right, so I've got blues in there and whites, and I've just added black. Right, so I'm going to add plenty of white. Right, away the existing colours and see what. Oh, that's nice. I like that. Let's see. I'm going for a kind of mountain effect here. I don't want it like battleship grey, you know. But it will not really matter, because the technique I'm going to use brings the mountain alive. Right, and I'll show you how I do that. Now, area-wise is alright. I think I've got enough paint to cover the area. We'll just take some of the brush. Right, so what I'm doing here is I'm going to follow this line. Right, that's maybe a wee bit dark, but remember what I said, I'm coming down in dominant colours. Right, this is going to take a wee bit of concentration here, because I only want to apply a wee bit here. I want a mountain to meet the sky, right, but I don't want it to lose its shape. Right, so take that over to the top right round. And I'll show you in a minute my technique, right? Again, doesn't matter if you go over a wee bit. In my last paintings I've done, I had snow on the mountains, but these mountains are just kind of mountains. That could pass as a wee bit of snow, I suppose. Anyway, I'm coming down the mountain now. So, once I get this done and the basic shape done, I'm going to move into mountain definition and cutting in. Right, so I'm going to use a smaller brush. And I'm going to take the paint off of this brush. You might think I'm being a bit tight, but paint is expensive. So you would bring a mountain alive, right? You'd imagine wee rocks and stuff. And ravines and, you know. You wouldn't just want it flat painted, you know. So you would give you an idea of gradients, you know. Again, cutting in here. Right, so you see what I've done here? Right, see if I can see it. Can you see it? Because the camera angle. But you would cut in. And again, you would follow the flow of the mountain. See what I'm doing here? You know, you would have a mountain coming down, gradiently, you know what I mean? Like adding life to the mountain. And where lighter patches appear and darker patches, and that doesn't matter. Just add your gradients. Makes it more exciting. And this is a bit I love doing. It's like when you're getting a lot of coverage and stuff and it's coming together. Right, so again, just apply gradient. You can even do these sound effects, like kind of building a mountain with molten and that, like before it ever became a mountain, you know. I would do that. People may think I'm a bit mad, but I think most artists were mad to a certain degree. This is me settling down the lava, right, and I'm going to give you an illusion here of this, that there's another wee mountain, kind of lesser peak there, right, just the illusion of, right, and just add more paint and stretching it out. Because you're not wanting a boring mountain, you're not wanting a boring mountain that just looks flat, you know. You want something with a bit of life in it. And the way you can add life to it is contrast and gradient. I'm just going to do that here again. Hold on a minute, we're going to leave that angry in a minute. You see what's happening here? See, I could even add a wee bit of green foliage later on as we come down off of the harshness of the mountain into the areas you know, trees and vegetation and plants and stuff. So I think that's what I'll do. Read the next sections. Let's go around that wee peak. I'm going to try Bob's technique here, crisscrossing. That seems to work. Right, you see what I've done here? It seems as if it's further away, and the white it's came through could just be light in places, if you know what I mean. Like, you imagine like a forest. I'll give you an idea, right? See, that's the trees. And the white part is just light on the trees or whatever. So, with that mountain in the background, I'm going to make it lighter coming down, right? So I'm going to add some green because I want to get into the vegetation and stuff now. And again, adding to the paint I've already used for volume. We're on 25 minutes, folks. I thought I could possibly do the whole paint in half an hour, but that's not been realistic. You know. So in fact, I'm just gonna have a wee mixture here. All of that, kinda, I want a kind of dark green for the next mountain, because I'm just going to do this one here. I don't know, it's too similar, so I would add mer green, right? And white, in fact, and a wee bit of blue. I'm not letting that as dark. In fact, I'll add a wee bit of white as well, because I'm not wanting it as dark as a back mountain. I'm just going to go for this here, right? There we go, I'm happy with that. So again, just take it up to meet the other one. Right, and you could have this one like a kind of lesser mountain, geologically speaking. You know, maybe a different kind of stone or moss growing on it or whatever. Whatever you're happy with. I don't like people that take art as an exact science, because I can assure you it's not. Every painting you do takes on a life of its own. I mean, look at this effect here. That would show maybe a wee clearing of some grass, plus trees and stuff as well. You could see appearing on a mountain. So I'm just going to bring that right in. There's quite a wee bit of contrast there, which I like. So again, a wee bit of light with the white coming through, and the gradient, the shape of the mountain, following the mountain round, which shape it would take naturally. There we go. That's another wee mountain there. And I'm just going to use a wee bit of white just to make a lighter mountain for here. Again, there's a natural division line appears between mountain peaks, you know. I'm happy with that effect, that looks good. So, just a wee bit there. Right, so I'm going to make it look as if this mountain is all going up to a peak, right? See that there, what I've done with the gradient? And then it comes down to the water. Right? Now I'm just looking and I want that definition a wee bit stronger. Because I feel it's getting lost, so I'll add a wee bit more darker paint. And just put in a division. Are you a wee bit darker yet, I think? Give that effect. That's what I'm after. See that here? Yeah. Just the division line that wee bit darker. Right, so that gives you contrast. And then it thins down. Now, using the colours I've already got, I'm quite happy that the land is all much the same, but with this mountain here, I'm going to spread the paint right out and make it as light as I can. So if you imagine that, that mountain there, the one in the background is coming round. Only a kind of hill if you like, you know. But again, with the colours. Once the colours are applied, I can concentrate on tones and stuff. Like I say, I want to get all the paint off this brush now. You know. Now what I'm going to do is, I'm going to stop after this mountain, which should take us to, I don't know, about 30, 40 minutes. I'm going to upload it. And if you've watched it, thanks for watching. And stay tuned for the next installment. Now, I want to guess a kind of, maybe a perfect mountain or hill. Although nothing's perfect, it could be perfectly imperfect. The idea is that we're coming round. And the initial concept for this painting was, let's see, when I meditate and stuff, and imagine walking mountains or whatever. Right, so I'm happy with that. I want to give us lighter, meeting the dark. Right, so that's as far as I'm going to take it for this wee session. I'm just putting my brush in the water. I hope you enjoyed. Oh no, I'll go back to my wee story about my meditation. And the concept of the painting is the mountain in life, and when you challenge yourself and you're always trying to get higher and higher, whatever. This is a journey path here, right? And you're starting your journey and you're walking in. This wee bit here is a continuation of the path and how you get through life with obstacles which appear as hills and mountains metaphorically, but you try to reach your peak, you try to reach your summit, you know. So I hope you enjoyed this wee part. Stay tuned and watch for other postings of when, depending on time, I should finish it, because the path is going to be a bit complicated. The rest of the mountains is going to be a wee bit time consuming. Not that time consuming, but the path will be. So we'll see how it goes from there. Thanks very much for your time. Have a lovely day. Bye bye.